Tore Soladas. Ki Adonai Hu Elohim. Enod Milvado.
What do you think? Is this a big occasion?
I think what you've done is a tremendous thing for the shul and also for the Melbourne community. And all of the board and the especially Rabbi David Kutnik, should be commended on doing such a fantastic job and retaining such a magnificent building in our city.
Well, mate, this is the big walk around. I'm in amongst it all now. We are going around and around. And it's a very joyous occasion here at East Melbourne Shul. All the people, personalities, including David Kuadlo. David Kuadlo. It's just been a great event.
Absolutely.
The biggest event I think Melbourne's had for a long time. Is that true?
That I'm not sure. But it's a very, very special event. A shul with so much history.
So much history.
So much Jewish history. 150 years of history.
155 years.
150.
55. Since the start. Yeah. 155 years.
The big nachas that the Rabbonim get from Melbourne is that we, in my electorate at least, we include East Melbourne in this, we have more shuls than churches.
How's that? Did you know that?
Unbelievable.
In your electorate?
Yeah, absolutely.
We have more shuls than we have churches. So
how's that? It's fantastic. And all of the Rabbonim from the different shuls are here. So it's
every one of them. It's a big occasion.
Big occasion.
Thanks, Michael. Michael Danby, MP.
It is not enough for you to be able to say to your children, we received the Torah from Moshe Rabbeinu. You have to make it new again in every generation. And that is why the halacha is, even if your parents left you a Sefer Torah in your, as your possession, nonetheless, it is a command on all of us, even if we have one already, to take a share in writing a new Sefer Torah, to make it new, generation after generation. And there is nothing more beautiful for a community as old as yours to see in these new Sefer Torah, this community become new again. Moshe Rabbeinu says, "Vata kiful lachem et hashira hazot." He does an odd thing. He says, he doesn't say, write for yourself this Torah. He says, write for yourself this song. Why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu was telling the Jewish people, if you want to hand the Torah on to the next generation, teach them to sing Torah, not just to speak Torah. Teach them to learn Torah, not just with their mind, but with their heart and with their emotions. And that is what we saw here in this wonderful shul today. Real song, real joy, of the kind of joy that only Jews really know how to do. We came from Parliament just now, is that right? That was the parliamentary building. And I once said, because I now kind of, for my many sins, or other people's, I'm not sure which, I now sit in the House of Lords. And in the House of Lords sit the supreme judges, the law lords of Britain. And I once said to the peers, can you imagine judges feeling so enthusiastic about English law that they each take in their hands a copy of Hallsbury's statutes and dance around the House of Lords? I said, here in the House of Lords, you see the majesty of the law. You see the grandeur of the law. You see the impartiality of the law. But if you want the joy of the law, for that you've got to come, not to the House of Lords, but to the House of Law of the Lord. Friend, that's what we have seen today. Real simcha, the simcha that comes to us through the Torah. May this new Torah, these two new Torahs, bring a double access of new joy to this community. May you carry the Torah for many years to come, and may it carry you to great blessing. Amen.
The Torahs are coming back from upstairs, and the ladies have had a kiss, and now the men will be kissing the cover as the Torah comes back to go back into the bima. Follow it.